What if focus could be trained, like a muscle, through play?
This is such amazing insight.
Sophie Hascher, founder of Brain Flow Elite, is using neurofeedback to gamify brain training. Each movement on screen is used to tune the mind itself.
We want you to be switched on and to be present in the moment.
Méline is here to find out if this technology can really change the way we think, feel, and focus. We're in London, where Méline is meeting Sophie Hascher, founder of Brain Flow Elite, a company that's turning brain training into something more. Using neurofeedback, Sophie helps people monitor their brain activity to sharpen focus, regulate emotions, and improve decision-making. Those brain signals are translated into live data, revealing how the mind reacts and adapts in real time.
So with the EEG, we can look at different brainwave activity and different patterns happening. And one of the things I usually look at is stress levels and then also calmness and relaxation levels.
The brainwaves that I'm usually interested in are theta brainwave activity, which is slower brainwave activity related to tiredness and also to burnout, and high beta, which is usually stress levels. And then we want to go into more of a flow state, so low beta activity slash alpha 2. So Méline, if you can clench your jaw for me. So everything that you do, like muscle movement, moving your arm, talking, will be recorded on the brain. So the EEG is very sensitive and happens really instantaneously. So one of the things that neurofeedback can do is actually train your brain in a very similar way than you would train your body in the gym. So instead of lifting weights, you would actually train your brain with everything that's happening on a screen. So one of the things that we do is actually looking at your brain in different states. So first doing a brain map. So how is your brain when you don't do anything in a more relaxed and calm state? And then we do a very similar thing with eyes closed. So just kind of simulating sleep in a way, and then two stress interventions to really show like how is your brain when something stressful happens. And then based on this, we understand clearly how your brain reacts in different situations and can create a protocol to then do that brain training to then increase your brain levels.
Okay, you can open your eyes again. Mm-hmm. And that's the end of the testing.
So what I always use is a relative power. So relative power is looking at how much percentage in your brain is there of that specific brainwave activity.
Okay.
Delta is the slowest brainwave activity. And then we have high beta, which is one of the fastest. This is the nose. And then we have the ears on the sides. And this will be then the back of the brain. High beta is related to stress levels, which is great because when your eyes are open, when you don't do anything, you're not highly stressed. Most of the activity happens in the slower brainwave activity, so delta and theta. So theta can be either related to tiredness scores. You mentioned that your sleep wasn't too great, so that might be one of the reasons. I was able to see also higher increase in theta activity during the recording. So for me, that almost shows that when your eyes are closed, you're almost like, okay, I'm ready to go to sleep, because the tiredness are quite increased in your brain. No worries at all, like we can train it. And train for your brain to just be a bit more awake. We want you to be switched on and to be present in the moment. So overall, I would say that your brain is in this slower brainwave activity, can be related to sleep. So tiredness, I would definitely look at your sleep activity overall and how then to train your brain to decrease this theta activity and increase low beta, which is then that calmness, focus, and more awake state. Let's do a quick monk intervention. Everything that is happening on the screen, you will be your brain controlling.
Okay.
So here you will be levitating a monk based on your thoughts. So whenever your tiredness levels decrease, the monk will be able to float. And whenever your tiredness levels are back, the monk will be at the bottom. We're going to train your brain. So different activities that you can do, like with your brain controlling a ship, controlling a monk. And then from there, we will actually be able to see the improvement in scores. So one of the things I love about this technology that I'm using is that you get scores similar to the Aura Ring. Mm. So Aura Ring is based on your sleep. I'm doing something similar based on your brain. So you will be able to see the enhancements in cognition and then also hopefully in your life overall to actually have better sleep and better emotion regulation. what we can train as well is not only do the games and do different games like the ship, the monk, controlling an airplane with your mind, but you can also watch your favorite TV show, watch your favorite podcast, and be able to train the brain this way. So here it's a very similar principle. Instead of, you know, levitating the monk and controlling the ship, it's terms of opacity and sound. So whenever the sound and the opacity are great, your tiredness level, so theta levels, will decrease and your focus, calmness, relaxation will increase.
That's so good, metaphor as a, you know, life in a sense, because you sometimes don't know your brain is powered off.
Yeah, I know. I really appreciate what you're saying, because I know for myself, like every time, especially when I just watch something, my mind wanders off and it just increases your self-awareness so much more.
Imagine in the future when all the devices, if you want to gamify it, to be able to train your brain. Yeah, but this is such amazing insight.
Sophie will be working with Méline for the next 5 days to see how much her brain can change. Together, they'll use a variety of techniques to stimulate her brain and measure how it adapts over time, from moments of deep focus to states of calm and recovery. Each session brings new data, new patterns, and a clearer picture of how Méline's brain responds to training. And at the end of it all, Sophie has her results.
So today I wanted to go over the reports that I created for you.
Okay.
So just to summarize what we've done a brain map on day one, and then we did 5 training sessions. Mm-hmm. And then we did a brain map again just to see the differences between before and after and what happened in your brain throughout the brain training sessions. We saw that the biggest increase you had was in cognition, where you started with a score of 69. And you went up to 75 with the brain training. There was also a slight increase in focus, so with 61, and then went up to 66. But we can definitely see that your brain is very receptive to the neurofeedback. So when we go back in terms of the brain maps, we saw that there was a big axis in overactivity in theta brainwave, meaning that your brain is in the slower brainwave activity, and we want your brain to shift a bit more towards alpha and low beta. So we want to shift the alpha peak from the left to the right, and this you can then do with the neurofeedback training. Considering we only did 5 sessions, it's already incredible to see that your scores increased in terms of the cognition, and the more you will actually train your brain, then you will see those big changes. We can see that where you excel very well is in terms of the focus score in alpha. So that looks at the frontal area, central area, and parietal area of the brain. Where you were a bit lower, but that was expected, is because your brain is in the lower brainwave activity, so theta is really prominent.
It was really interesting. The other day we do a little experiment in measuring the brain with gong. And in general, do you have any thoughts on how the music or how the sound influence our brain?
Music definitely has so much power. There were some experiments that have been done in clinical settings where they actually show that classical music was able to heal patients. During the gong, we actually saw that at the crescendo, there was a peak of theta activity. So theta activity, when you have your eyes closed, is related to like deep relaxation. So I wanted to hear about your experience in the neurofeedback. What changes happened subjectively for you, and how do you feel now?
For me, I realized my brain really like to solve things and piece the puzzle together. I kind of secretly judge myself why I always have to do so many things to keep myself energized. Mm. And I realized, think about my own life, that the moment I start to rest, actually I feel more tired. I'm less motivated, but the more I'm doing in the flow state, or is the thing made me feel okay, there are comfortable or I could solve something, that really excites me. So I think only that inside itself, it makes me feel like I can be more compassionate to myself.
It's so interesting because like when we did the more like mathematical and harder games, like I could see you were really, really focused, and it also showed in the brainwave activity.
After 5 days of training, Méline's brain scores have improved, showing clearer focus and better self-regulation. Sophie's guidance has offered invaluable insight into how adaptable the brain can be, and how small, consistent training can reshape the way we think and feel.
Thank you for watching this new episode of the HumanWare Project. So that we can experiment and try new technology together, please like and subscribe. Your support means the world to us.